Yes, Debbie. So what do we have here? Well, we have a budget that would increase deficit spending by more than $300 billion. Not a penny more for essentials like ICE immigration enforcement, and next to nothing for construction of the wall. You have plenty of money for Obamacare, and so the pending fiscal disaster creeps closer and ever so closer. Joining me now from Dallas, Texas, co-founder and chief strategist of GDP Advisors, Seth Denson. Seth, let's go to the debt clock, shall we? I like to look at the debt clock once in a while, and it keeps ratcheting upward always. It's over $23.1 trillion. Fiscal year 2019, that's the previous fiscal year, there was a deficit of $1 trillion. Now, I went to a state university, Seth, so it takes me a little while to do the math. But so last year's was $1 trillion, or $300 billion more. That's $1.3 trillion we're going to add. We're getting close to $25 trillion in operating debt. When exactly does all this fiscal insanity end? How does it end?
I don't know why we're not already there, Graham. I mean, the reality is maybe if we'd spend some more time behind closed doors with a calculator or, heck, even an abacus, rather than trying to find ways to impeach a president, maybe we could find a way to get this budget under control. But Washington bipartisanly has a spending habit, and we must address this. Otherwise, our children and our grandchildren and our great-grandchildren are going to have to.
And the only legitimate spending in my mind right now is defense spending. And it is a decent part of the budget, but when you look at it as a whole, it's certainly not a majority. That is the number one job of the federal government. That is defend the United States of America. And when you look at it compared to automatic spending, it's the automatic spending. You know, nobody has a budget at home with automatic spending. I mean, yeah, you got to pay your mortgage every month, and that's, in a sense, automatic. But it's not automatic in the sense that you can't sell your home if you want to. This is automatic spending. It's written in stone. So we have defense spending is minute compared to the automatic spending. It's highway robbery in the end, Seth. It's highway robbery for the future of this republic. Maybe not for you and me, but for our kids and our grandkids.
That's right. As we start to think about what makes us competitive on the global market, we have to understand that our global competitors are thinking long term. Think about China. They have a 100-year plan. We don't seem to have a 100-minute plan anymore. We're just spending and spending.
Yeah. And so, you know, on the one hand, we have this strong economy. We have some good numbers coming in. We have a record-breaking stock market. On the other hand, we have a federal government that seems to be blind to what it's doing, which is condemning the future of this country to a very bleak financial picture. It's not an if, it's a when. Seth, thank you.